Hello, we are continuing with the third chapter, Techniques and Methods of Motivation at Work. 4. Defining organizational motivation. Over time, the concept of motivation has been given different interpretation depending on the purposes underlying the analysis, but in general, motivation refers to the internal states of necessity of the body that guides and directs behaviors towards satisfaction and, therefore, of its removal. According to the Explanatory Dictionary of the Romanian language, motivation represents the totality of motive or consequences or not that determine someone to perform a certain action or to aim at certain goals. It follows that the basis of human behavior is always a set of motives that support the performance of certain action and that sensitize the person differently to external influences, making him more or less permeable to them. Thus, one of the same external influence produces different effects in different people or in the same person at a different time of its existence. The term motivation comes from Latin movere, which means movement. Starting from this, we could deduce that anything that set in motion the behavior of the individuals would fall within the sphere of motivation. However, as not only motivation sets the body in motion, but also many other elements, there's a need to specify more precisely the scope of the notion of motivation. Thus, in order to differentiate motivation from other forces or stimuli of behavior, we will consider as it as reportable to the individual decision-making process through which people operate on the type of behavior they will adopt in order to achieve the proposed objectives. This way of interpreting motivation excludes instinctive or reflexive action, focusing instead on individual choice.